Hey, this is Dr. K from iMedicalSchool, and today we're going to do a USMLE Step 1 practice question. Let's say there's an 84-year-old male with a past medical history of hypertension, hyperlipidemia, and progressive dementia who passes away at home. He undergoes an autopsy to identify the cause of his dementia. Of note, no cogwheel rigidity, micronathia, movement abnormalities, or tremor was noted prior to his passing. What are the most likely histological findings on brain biopsy? Is the answer A, multinucleated giant cells, B, Lewy bodies, C, neurofibrillary tangles, D, broad-based budding yeast, or E, prions? Take some time and pause here to think it over. Otherwise, let's look at the answer choices to find out the correct answer. There's some key points to note from the stem of the question. Remember, to always think of common things first, and when answering a question, do not assume facts that are not given in the question stem. From the stem of this question, we know we have a patient who has progressive dementia, meaning his dementia did not come on suddenly. Infectious causes of dementia tend to be more rapid in nature and are accompanied by infectious symptoms such as fevers, chills, cough, or gastrointestinal symptoms. The question clearly points out there is no cogwheel rigidity, which is a sign of Parkinson's disease, where movement of a Parkinson's patient's extremity is very difficult. In addition, there's no evidence of micronathia, which is when a Parkinson's patient writes very small as a result of their disease. Lack of these movement disorders also rule out Parkinson's disease and other similar movement disorders as a cause of his dementia. Given these findings, let's proceed to look at the answers. Our first potential choice is multinucleated giant cells. As the name sounds, multinucleated giant cells are large cells that have more than one nucleus. They tend to arise during an active mycobacterium infection. These giant cells will eventually form the granuloma seen in long-standing tuberculosis infection. Multinucleated giant cells may be also seen in Langerhans cells histiocytosis. In the end, they are associated with areas of inflammation. Here we have a picture demonstrating these multinucleated giant cells. Given infection is not a high consideration here, since there are no infectious symptoms or risky exposures, this makes A unlikely, especially since TB meningitis would not likely cause a progressive dementia. Choice B is Lewy bodies. Lewy bodies are associated with a type of dementia called Lewy body dementia. Lewy body dementia is the second most common cause of dementia after Alzheimer's disease. Lewy body dementia is associated with fluctuations in cognition, visual hallucinations, and Parkinsonian symptoms. The Parkinsonian symptoms include limb rigidity, gait disturbances, and difficulty initiating movements, otherwise known as akinesia. In this picture, we have a depiction of a Lewy body seen as a small sphere in the cytoplasm of the cell surrounded by brown pigmented material. Given our patient in this stem has no Parkinson's symptoms with dementia, makes Lewy body dementia unlikely. As a result, we would not expect Lewy bodies present on histology. Choice C is neurofibrillary tangles. These tangles are phosphorylated tau proteins that have accumulated in the neurocortical regions of the brain, leading to Alzheimer's dementia. The tangles appear as whiffs of protein collections, almost look like candle flames in the neuron, as depicted in this picture. Alzheimer's is a progressive dementia and is the most common cause of dementia in the elderly. Alzheimer's is characterized by a loss of recent memory, including names and dates. No movement disorders are seen in Alzheimer's, and it is a progressive dementia. Though this choice fits very well with a progressive non-infectious dementia, let's make sure none of the other choices fit well. In choice D, we have broad-based budding yeast. The description of these yeasts indicates a blastomyces infection. Blastomycosis infection is unlikely to cause a chronic progressive dementia. The description of how yeast appear microscopically is very important. For example, the question says there's appearance of spaghetti and meatballs on a skin biopsy. Think tinea versicolor. Also, if a fruity body is present with 45 degrees septate hypha, think aspergillus. These are a few examples. Check out the link in the description below to find a handout about the description of various fungi, and let me know if the handout helps. This brings us to our last choice, choice E, which is prions. Prions are abnormally folded proteins that deposit within the brain parenchyma, leading to cell death. Prions lead to diseases like Kuru or Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. Prions were made famous because these are infectious protein chains that are known to cause mad cow disease in cows. CJ disease presents as dementia, and generally patients have a cortical spinal tract involvement, causing hyperreflexia, Babinski sign, and spasticity. Given our patient does not have these symptoms, this makes prion disease unlikely. In the end, it looks like the patient had Alzheimer's disease, but it's important to keep a broad differential and learn how to narrow your differential based on the clinical presentation. I hope you enjoyed this video and the handout below. If you did, please give this video a like. If you have any comments or questions, place them in the comment section down below. Share this video with your friends on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. You can follow us on Twitter at iMedSchool and on Facebook and Google+ at iMedicalSchool. And most importantly, subscribe. This is Dr. K from iMedicalSchool, and I'll see you next time.